A walk within the busy Kilifi town may not give you any slightest idea of the monumental problems facing this region. Not until you visit Ganze, where villagers here are on the brink of starvation. Their road to starvation began when their crops failed due to prolonged drought, with Kilifi County government estimating that about 300,000 area residents are in dire need of relief food. A few miles away, when we arrive at Ngamani village in Ganze sub-county, we meet 70-year-old Sheti Kombe. In deep thought, he stares, maybe wondering what is going to become of him and his elderly wife. His only son, who was the family's breadwinner, was brutally killed early this year when terrorists descended on Mpeketoni, leaving behind a wife and 7 children under his care. The elderly Kombe and his wife have no one to take care of them. When hunger came knocking, his daughter-in-law was forced to flee the home, leaving behind her 7 children under his care. He says children no longer go to school, and if the situation is not addressed, lives risk being lost. Emaciated with little strength left in him, he hopes his grandchildren will access education and navigate the challenges brought about by poverty as the situation is currently. This is the famous Mworya seeds that Mzee Kombe and his family has been feeding on as a source of food. But if the relief supply is not consistent, this family will go back to eating these. In Jila village, we also come across a group of women and children gathered under a tree. But here, we are taken aback when we witness these little angels scramble for the scarce roasted Mworya seeds. So dire is the situation that school compounds have been deserted, with pupils here opting to look for wild fruits.
Hali ya njaa ni ngumu. Watoto wakitoka nyumbani, wakati ndio ambao sikuwafundisha darasani, ikifika mwendo wa saa 4 na nusu wameanza kulala kwenye mabao. Sasa naendelea kuamsha ili wasikize vile ambavyo nawafundisha. Kabla saa haijafika, wanaharakisha kwa sababu huwa wanasikia njaa.
A few kilometers away, at Silala village, we bump into children sitting outside their house next to a fire with the elder ones pounding what is meant to be their last meal. The children's innocent faces are testament that in this state, they cannot even go to school. Rehema Kazungu is preparing a meal for her family. Her last-born son, Mwakole, looks emaciated and even sits on his mother's lap as she prepares the meal.
This is Rehema's family of 5, and this is probably their last meal. This is the last of the relief food she received. Tomorrow is another day. Back to square one.
Rehema is among others who plowed their land, but their crops failed due to the prolonged drought, and now all she can do is depend on relief food to feed her family.
Watoto wangu sijui watakula nini. Njia iko chakula inakuja lakini hata kwangu saa nyingine sipati. Naishia kwa wengine. Sasa mimi bado nakumbana na hao watoto.
These families are among thousands who have been reduced to food beggars and are now calling for increased relief food.
This is the famous Mworya tree that residents of Ganze have been feeding on this dry spell. The hunger here is real. All they can do is wait for well-wishers to bring relief food. Reporting from Ngamani village, I am Ann Mburu.